lips I have kissed, call tenderly out of the west, hands I have pressed, beckon to me over the sea. Waiting for me, lonely and blue. Somebody sighs, somebody cries, I love you, I love you. Drifting in dreams, drifting in dreams.
Oh, that's your mom?
Yeah, she's like, you want to take a permaculture class? And I was like, she's like, too bad, you're doing it anyway. Okay,
that's cool.
Yeah,
yeah. Once more, heart of my heart, no more we'll part. I hear her say, but at the dawn, my dreams have gone astray.
I think of permaculture as being an important sort of life tool. It affords us a mechanism by which we can organize both the problems we see in the world as well as the diversity of solutions that we have to them into a cohesive framework for navigating social and ecological systems to create more positive futures. So the Permaculture Design Certificate course is sort of a protracted introduction to permaculture overall. And so this first weekend is really about, the first couple days are really about setting a solid foundation of understanding in the ethics, the history, the principles, and the approaches, and sort of the context of how we approach problem solving through permaculture design.
You can think about zones in terms of home personal use, and you can think about zones in terms of social use. Kind of think about zones in terms of your work structure. So there's a lot of different structure of zones that we can think about here. But we'll just try to kind of focus in on your home zone.
And so folks that go through the full permaculture design certificate course, which is based on a 72-hour curriculum, it's sort of your ticket to play in the permaculture world, to say. The term permaculture is sort of vested in the graduates of the permaculture design courses, and so it can then be utilized in your professional work, as well as used as sort of a chit for introduction to more advanced coursework, as well as into teaching and further endeavors.
I've grown up on Oahu pretty much my whole life, and I always loved nature, but I never really got a chance to learn and get to know a lot more about it in this class. Maybe it'll give me a chance to start farming and growing local plants and giving back to Oahu and just trying to rebuild it better and hopefully have my own garden someday.
Scion appreciated living here because this trifoliate, so this sort of three-branch leaf rootstock, is really common with citrus, and so it's one thing to sort of keep an eye for as you come into orchards.
I think probably one of the most interesting things is how the problem can be the solution, and in how ways where it's not all set one way that we have to do things, and permaculture kind of gives you a way to give it your own like originality and make it unique and to your own style that works.
So, my name is Drew Wilkinson, and I'm helping assist with some of the modules here at the 2015 monthly permaculture design course. And yeah, this is kind of the first weekend of the course, and one of my passions is spreading the knowledge of how to grow your own. And so what I've come up with is a grow your own challenge for all of the students in the permaculture design course to grow something within the 6 months of the course, and then during the last weekend we all share some of our harvest together to contribute towards our potluck dinner. So I brought in a couple of things from to share from my resources. We got cassava, we got some pigeon pea, and an assortment of other quick growing plants in hopes that students will take this and green up their thumbs a little more, and we can grow together towards promoting more food security and healthy intake of vitamins and nutrients into our bodies and share it with each other. So grow your own challenge.
Because when you grow your own food, you eliminate a lot of these external costs. External costs to the environment, external costs to the future. So it kind of falls, it's this huge umbrella, it's trickling down.
So we chose the Hawai'i Farms, or the Reppun Family Farm, because it really exemplifies a lot of the different principles and approaches embodied through permaculture design. They've been a diversified organic production hub for almost four decades now. And so the variety of different species that they cultivate and the approach that they take to it really exemplify, as they term it, we could say, an endemic form of agriculture.
So the area below, which is a little more reachable, I'm thinking we would plant something like kapa. Yeah. But the area above is where we want to plant kukui and try to shade this out as much as possible. So we got 19 kukui.
So essentially you're going to have one group there, one group there. Somebody else can start on the
citrus. The citrus has been badly abused in the last 10 years, so it needs cleaning around, pulling the wodelia back.
And we are clearing back all this wodelia, which is a weed in this case. And we're also trimming back the graft starts here. We're trimming back anything that grows below where the graft starts so that the mandarin will grow instead of the rootstock. And just getting these ready to put some compost and some bone meal and get them a little healthier.
And we've been pulling this up to kind of make this more of a showcase, aesthetically pleasing for the owners. And then here we found a Jamaican lily koi vine, we believe, which we're keeping intact.
Beautiful.
With hopes that we'll be able to have some fruit from this vine.
Like you started, you cut the ring around the top basically, and then this is your end result, what you're looking for right here. And what it does is it's going to interrupt the tree's ability to send water and nutrients rest of it, which is obviously part of its life process.
And it's an invasive species.
And because it's an invasive species, we can forgive ourselves.
We don't have to hug this tree.
No. You can tell it congratulations. Sorry about that. But it ain't no family member.